To better understand material later in the course, it's important that we cover some basic internet concepts. In this introduction, we will explore internet basics and definitions and start to discuss the World Wide Web. Let's start with the concept of networks. Networks are a group of computers that are connected to enable communication between them. You can have a network at home with two computers, which would be a local area network, or at work with 200 computers in multiple locations all networked together, which would be a wide area network. You may have heard at school, the Blackboard server is down, or someone at work may say, we need to reboot the email server. What exactly are they talking about? Well, a server is a special computer that does just that. It serves files and other information to computers it's attached to on the network, which are clients. When you're at home on the internet, your computer is a client connected to a server from your internet service provider. We'll talk about internet service providers in a few minutes. You can connect to the internet in several different ways. The most common types of internet connections are dial-up, DSL, and cable. Dial-up uses your regular telephone line. It's the slowest and cheapest type of connection. It's the least used connection now because large files are difficult to view or download. For example, if you are trying to upload or download pictures, watch videos, or listen to music, dial-up would be the connection that would give you the most difficulty trying to do these things. High-speed connections allow you to use the internet more effectively. DSL, or digital subscriber lines, use a special type of digital line usually provided by your telephone company. Cable high-speed allows you to use your cable lines with special modems to access the internet. With both types, the connection speed is high, and you can easily download and view large files. Regardless of the type, in order for you to access the internet, a company needs to make the connection work. This company is called an Internet Service Provider, or ISP. Examples of ISPs include AOL, Brighthouse, CenturyLink, and Comcast. Let's move on to the World Wide Web. Many people use the terms Internet and World Wide Web, or Web, interchangeably. However, this isn't the case. The Internet is the actual wide area network of computers around the globe. The World Wide Web is a virtual collection of websites connected by hypertext. When viewing web pages, there are certain words or images that, when clicked, allow you to go to a different web page. This ability to go to different web pages internally or externally is called hypertext. Hypertext is a system that allows objects, such as documents or images, to be linked to one another. You can click on hyperlinks on a web page, which are often underlined in blue, to access connected content either within the same website or on another network. Since web pages are stored on servers connected to the internet, the World Wide Web is a part of the internet. Now, complete the activity for this video, and then continue on to What is the Internet Part 2.